Okay, welcome back to part two of the physical assessment video. Next, we're gonna assess the lower extremities and then the patient's back. If you are worried about your patient rolling out of bed for safety, you do wanna go ahead and raise the side rail back up. And then we are gonna lower the sheets and make sure her gown is lowered. So in general, I'm looking at the legs. I'm looking for any edema. So I do not note any edema. I'm also feeling for color and temperature changes. So her feet and legs feel nice and warm. I'm gonna go ahead and assess the pedal pulses, and we're doing that bilaterally. And that is equal and 2+. We also wanna assess the patient's strength and range of motion. So we're looking at the hip and the knees. So I'm gonna lift up this leg. I'm just gonna bend up, okay. I'll lift up the other leg. Perfect. And can you do that with this leg for me as well? And the next leg. Perfect. So then also looking at her feet, I want to take a look at her toenails and at her toes. If the patient has toenail polish on, you can check cap refill just above the nails. So less than 2 seconds. You do want to go ahead and check the bottom of the patient's feet. So at the bottom of the ankles, remember all bony prominences, you're looking for any skin breakdown or wounds. And I do not see any wounds or breakdown. Can you go ahead and lift up with your feet against my hands? Perfect. And push down against my hands? Good job. Okay, so the patient has full strength and range of motion in the lower extremities. So since I touched the patient's feet, I am gonna go ahead and sanitize my hands again. And if you had gloves on, you would wanna go ahead and change your gloves. I am actually gonna go ahead and put gloves on because I am gonna assess her back, but then I'm also gonna look at her buttocks. And if you ever are concerned that you might come into contact with any body fluid or body substances, you would wanna have gloves on for protection. So I'm going to put gloves on just because I'm looking at your back and then your bottom, okay?
Okay.
And what I'm looking for is just any breakdown in your skin. Okay. Can you go ahead? I'm going to lower the bed just a little bit. And if your patient needed assistance rolling over, you, depending on their size, you could either assist them yourself or you'd have another person assist you. Can you go ahead and bend this knee for me, please? Okay, and then I'm gonna have you roll over and hold onto that side rail, please. Oops. So I'm gonna go ahead and first listen to the patient's lung sounds and just keep taking deep breaths in and out. Okay, so when you're listening to posterior breath sounds, you want to make sure that you're not listening over the patient's scapula. So you start kind of close to the spine, yep, and for a full inspiratory and expiratory cycle in each spot. And as you go down the patient's back, you would widen out. And then always make sure that you listen underneath the patient's arm. Okay. Your lungs sound nice and clear. And then I'm just looking at your skin. I can reassess the back of the patient's head, and I do not see any hair loss or skin breakdown. If the patient had a trach, you would want to make sure you specifically pay attention to the back of the neck. I do not see any skin breakdown on the bony prominences. And then I'm looking at the patient's back at the coccyx, and I do not see any skin breakdown. This is another time that you can look at the back of the feet to make sure that you have assessed them correctly. Okay, perfect. Miss Griego, you can go ahead and lay back down. Okay. How are you feeling?
Good.
Okay. Is there anything I can get for you?
No.
No? I want to make sure that you have your colite and you know how to use that, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And your IV is still intact. Okay, well, thank you very much, Ms. Griego. So that concludes the end of part two of physical assessment, and I hope to see you next time.